Hello YouTube, Reddit Math here, and welcome back to No Man's Sky. Got a little family, a cute, adorable, three-tailed whatchamacallits running around in front of us. And it popped up briefly in the lower right-hand corner there. You may have noticed the game telling me that I needed to find zinc. It was actually being quite helpful, as if I scan the zinc icon, is going to be this little gold bar right over here. So the game was telling us, like, repair starship pulse engine, gather 20 or more zinc. This is the zinc icon. There's zinc right over here. Need 20 of it. We got 18 for doing that. I also, before I go looking around for more gold bars, the green bar, or the neutral from copper, this seems to be pretty rare. I don't know what's going on with this planet's gravity that causes things like this to just float, but, that's just inventory full, like the worst words in a video game. I'll tell you what, let's, transfer that back, because I have no idea what it does, and, we'll get rid of the aluminium as well, and then we'll mine for some more copper, as long as it's here, and I haven't been seeing copper as a very, like, consistent find. So, again, I don't have a great concept yet of, like, what is rare and what is just super common, but, like, I've only seen it once, so I'm going to assume that it is more rare than some of the other materials. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time here just getting this copper vein. Oh, God. I feel like one of these days... Yeah. One of these days, falling off of a ledge while I'm just not paying attention, probably going to be the literal death of me. Alright, so maybe let's stay up here and just shoot the copper without walking around it and trying to be all cinematic. And I'm not going to worry, like, I feel like the... That's weird. The amount of... Okay, that is purposeful. The amount of effort, maybe. Alright, there's a definite range on our mining laser that we can't get all of it. Alright, so several things happening here. One, the amount of effort spent on, like, trying to catch, like, just the little tiny particles, probably not worth it. Like, some of the little bits that end up floating by themselves sometimes. But I just want to get, like, all of the kind of big chunks out of this. The other thing I'm noticing is that sort of... I don't know how to describe it. The grid kind of texture overlay. We're actually not even going to be able to get like the higher up parts of this. It looks like they're just going to be out of our range because they're too high up in the air. So sort of the grid-like overlay that was happening on this copper item. That... Oh, like I don't know... Because no one knows, but... Ooh, fancy Gek charm. I don't know the plot of No Man's Sky, like the game world and what's going on here. But I'm starting to get these hints of like we're in maybe a VR environment or something like that. That this might be a computer simulation. Sort of hinted at by us starting out jacking into something, but there continue to be hints of it sort of all around us. Now I need carbon to get this back up, and I can't just like get carbon, right? Is this a way? Because this is destroying this. I'm curious, like there can't be a failure state, right? Where, like, I literally cannot get anything. Like, I'm out of carbon. I have no isotopes. This doesn't appear to be giving us anything, but we are damaging it. So I'm wondering if when it gets to zero, is it going to explode into little carbony bits that I'm able to just suck up? better now than later, I suppose, we find out the answer to this. And okay, so we do get carbon from that. All right, more iron there. Okay, so that's good to know. That answers that question. We cannot ever run out of resources. All right, but weird little eyeball growing out of that, by the way. Of course, this is quite a bit more efficient than the other method. Also, that's an icon I've not seen before. Pretty sure there's a sentinel right behind me. Knowledge stone. I didn't do it. You didn't see me. I'm not even here. Oh man. Okay. I'm still getting a little worried. I don't quite know where the threshold for these guys is all the time. Okay. Got turned around. Knowledge stone over here. You have learned the Korvax word for rare. Alright. So there are going to be NPCs to interact with. Alright. Thermally protection. It is negative 31 degrees, so we're probably going to want to not die from frostbite. There are NPC aliens to interact with. Definitely on spaceships. Or on spaceships. On space stations. And probably on planets as well. Like, what is that down there? That looks like another spaceship down there. Let's head this way. We'll continue to look for zinc, so anything that's the little gold bar, we'll check with it. We just need a couple more. Yeah, with this thing. Also, some things we can interact to just grab, like the plants. But they're never carbon interact with. Like, this would have been way faster, right? We could have just punched a thing a couple of times and gotten at least enough carbon to charge up our mining laser for a second or two. Okay. There's so many things I want to do. I want to do literally everything. That's how I feel every time I'm starting to do something, is I want to do literally everything. So, our ship is this way. Our starship is a minute and 18 seconds this way, but this is another crash site. And another spaceship. If this was many other games, I would be questioning whether or not we were going to encounter another player? Like, I'm not that lucky, right? Niogawa S65. What? Interact? It's another ship? Another crash ship? A better crash ship? Phase beam photon cannon. What? Deflector shields. Its pulse engines are also destroyed. Its launch thrusters are destroyed. Its phase coolant is offline. And then it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 inventory in it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11 inventory. But like, way more guns, right? How do I make this my ship? Can I make this my ship? Compare and transfer stuff. I'm overlooking stuff in the UI all the time. Abandoned starship, 16 slots. I want the thing. I want I want the thing. Just because it's not the starter thing, I think is kind of why I want the thing. So of course I did spend time getting my launch thrusters repaired, which I'm now going to need to do again. But it requires different things this time. Maybe it was damaged in a different way? Iridium carrot sheet zinc. Zinc. Huh. Okay. I wanna check out the new ship. My new ship. The Ninogawa S-65 new ship. Awesome. So we're just gonna find like other crash ships around that are just better than our current ship. That's super awesome. An Atlas Pass version 1 required. Well, I don't have an Atlas Pass. That doesn't seem fair at all. Shielding plates. And even if we weren't going to have wanted to take this ship, we would be able to interact with like all this stuff. So it would have just been like a prime loot spot, even without that. And we got this thing again. Korvax distress beacon. The high-tech ship's emergency systems activate as I climb on board, and a hologram appears before me. The lights in the mask it wears seem wide and dim. The pilot calmly reports news of its imminent demise. The noise of explosions and tearing metal can be heard. The hologram disappears, leaving an array of glittering technologies and devices behind it. Some of them still look operational. Search for functioning technology? Research ship carries fascinating technological advances. I scan a blueprint. I can now construct one of these advances myself. Phase beams. I can make laser devices. Oh, very cool. New technology discovered. Oh, yeah. All right, well, that is pretty neat. Damaged machinery over here. Advanced cooling sigma already known. Photon cannon companion blueprint. Alright, maybe I should do something about my life support power before it reaches zero. That feels like the next step after 25. Alright, also gonna take carbon. Okay, I have a new ship. I have the same problem as my old ship, which is that my pulse engines are actually ready to be repaired. Now, launch thrusters. Now I need iron. Now I need iron. So, craft kerite sheets. Kerite sheets. Don't have enough for more kerite sheets. Okay. Refuel launch thrusters. Ooh, there's now like a little healthy plus thing on the radar. Okay, I want... Starship repair, sure. Well, kind of. I guess I broke the tutorial a little bit. I repaired half of one ship and half of the other. So I am actually going to want to get to enough iron to make a few more kerite sheets. And I think oxides are the lightning bolts? Am I remembering correctly? No, isotopes. Silicates. I guess we might as well take these. Hey, there's like random platinum just laying around. You want some? Like, yes, I want the platinum. Okay, so it's neither of those. Okay, so again, these are silicates. Yep, life support, got it. And these are isotopes. Iron, you know, would make sense, tended to be more of a, like, mineral from rocky, outcropping-y type stuff. Oh, did I just get a prompt to feed you? Get back here, little three-tailed man! Feed! I don't have enough carbon. Oh, get some carbon. Then we're gonna feed you. Oh, you know it's happening. That's enough carbon to feed you. Wait, where did you go? There you go. Come, oh, come here. Come, stop running in weird circles. Oh, I fed you. You liked that. You liked being fed. Oh, it's got a little smiley face above him. I have no idea what that did. Did you, for me? Substance. Zinc. You brought me 4 zinc in exchange for my 20 carbon. I mean, I guess that's pretty cool. I would have accepted like a pet option or something similar. Are you gonna stick around? Okay. I've tamed my first wild alien specimen, which I'm pretty happy with. Is it actually following me? Because, like, that would be pretty awesome. Alright. We were looking for iron. I'm gonna get so distracted playing this game, just on a fairly constant basis. Okay. There should just be iron everywhere. Exosuit. Send titanium, send zinc, send copper. Running out of space left, right, and center, man. Okay. Let's charge up our life support a little bit. Let's charge up our multi-tool a whole lot. Like, with plutonium. Charge up this with more plutonium. Man, plutonium is the way to go as a power source, it seems. And then starship, exosuit, collect more iron. Oh, lots of iron. You should probably... That's not what I want to do to it. This should probably be enough. I just needed... another 100, was it? 75 right there. Maybe it was like 53, actually. It was a rock, okay? The rock did not have feelings. Look, I made that thing happy. Do you see it? It's happy. Okay. I feel like it's one of those stand very still and it won't notice you moments. Okay. It continues to... I feel like it was showing up on my mini-map, right? It's like a little... magnifying glass symbol? Was that imagined by me? It might have been imagined by me. Okay. Let's get back to our starship where we need the launch thrusters. We need 2 more of those. That's unfortunate. I kind of filled up its inventory, which is now preventing me from really being able to... It dug up more substance. It gave me more zinc. It's like the gift that keeps on zinking. Okay. So I guess it will, like, continue to dig up things for me. I'm not quite sure if it's following me or if I've just sort of stayed in its general vicinity this whole time. I think I might have just been staying in its vicinity. Oh, God. watch where you're going, Red. Watch where you're going. Okay, let's get back over here so that we can manage some inventory space a little bit. That's not what I want to do. So we can manage some inventory space a little bit. And let's take our iron back. And then... Can we craft? We can. Take that back. And then craft. Okay. Then we'll get launch thrusters repaired. Alright, now we've got launch thrusters are up. Pulse engines are up. Our phase coolant is damaged. Phase coolant tau. A phase beam companion unit. Phase beam laser cooldown times are significantly reduced. Okay, so these are just helping our guns be better at being guns. It might be worthwhile to get our iron and thamium up so that we can get this ship just like fully repaired. Yeah, I could see that being probably a good idea. I'll tell you what, let's send that back. Send that back. And then thamium's at 60. Okay. And actually, one final thing. It doesn't show me the little... That's a little annoying to me, only because I haven't learned them yet. But it doesn't show me the symbol right here that it would show up as on the map. Which I kind of wish it did. Alright, iron, thamium 9. I need these things. This is going to be iron right over here. I also feel like I can... Yep. Like I can sense that little guy buzzing around behind me, watching my every move. Like, what are you doing to that rock over there? Nothing. Nothing. Nothing's happening to the rock. Why are you asking? Okay, that's very little return on investment there for just a couple of iron. I feel like maybe you just want to get away from the scene of the crime as quickly as possible. Like, you don't want them to scan a thing that's been destroyed and then immediately scan you as well. Is that what sets them off at you? We may never know. Or at least we may not know extremely soon. Thamium. Who here remembers where we got our thamium from? Anybody? Euler? Can we not? We don't appear. Oh, is it the... It's this thing under it. No? It's just indestructible. Okay, I can buy indestructible too. Oops, thamium. Oh, I need thamium. Thamium. What are you? Get back here. You are also fairly adorable. You wanted something. What do you want? Come back here! Little cute thing. 100 carbon. Man! Greedy! How much carbon do I have? I mean, I don't have a lot of carbon. I have 8 carbon. Okay. Well, I'm sorry, friend, but I'm probably not going to go on a carbon harvesting spree just yet. Okay. I tell you what, so I feel like I'm going to be doing a lot of this, and early on especially, it's going to take me a little bit to sort of get my pacing for what I do want to include and what I don't want to include. Right now, I feel like I want to show you guys just all of the crazy me wandering around and shooting at floating copper and et cetera, et cetera. Eventually... That's probably not going to be the case, right? You guys aren't going to need to see literally everything that I'm doing. What I feel like I'm going to do right now is go find enough Thamium 9 to repair my ship fully. And then I want to pick up with you guys back at my ship so that we can see... also, emerald? That's something I've never seen before. Oh, and we've got another question mark over there. Oh, man. There's just stuff everywhere. I want to get off the planet, but at the same time, I want to do everything on the planet. And these two motivations conflict just a little bit. I don't really have a purpose for emerald. I guess maybe instead of thinking... hey, that's rare. I should always, you know, I should be grabbing that. I've never seen it before. Well, maybe if I'd never seen it before, then I don't need to be getting it because it doesn't do anything for me. I've traveled 5,000 yus. Oh man. There's more Heridian. Lots of it now. Like maybe these elements like don't serve any purpose for me. Oh, there's birds. Am I too far away from the birds? I think I might be. I can't seem to analyze them. Okay, so many competing things that I would like to do right now. I want to get the ship repaired, and I want to take off. That is my... Oh, there's this dangerous animal on my mini-map there. But before I take off, I want to get my ship fully repaired. I know I don't have to do this in order to launch. Like, these are weapon systems, but I want to have the ship fully repaired before I take off, because I don't know how difficult it'll be to repair, and I don't know what's going to happen in space, so maybe those guns will turn out to be more important than I think they will be just any minute. So I'm going to cut out a little bit here as I go around and explore, and I'll meet up with you guys in a minute. Okay, and I know I said I was going to pick back up at my ship, but I saw this guy in the distance, and then I had to go look at him. Because look at this thing! Oh my god, it is so ridiculous. Get back here! It is submissive and a grazing creature. Maybe I should have scanned it from farther away, you know, as to not get attacked by something that was mean. And I'm assuming I could get up close and feed. I could. It needs way more carbon than I've got there. It's a biped. Like, that's crazy. I didn't think... And it's like wearing a... I'm at a masquerade ball mask. Oh, look at its little mouth. Whoa. Okay. I've not forgotten. I'm still looking for the isotope. I'll be back. Alright, we're back at our new ship, where I'm going to be able to repair photon cannons, and then I'm going to be short of Heridium in order to get phase coolant all the way up. Oh my god! It's spiraling out of control. It's never enough! It's never enough! I'll be right back. We'll do this. I promise. Alright, I think I've got everything this time, barring any other miscalculations. Is kind of cool. Our thermal shielding is going down due to how cold it's gotten at night. So I think like one dose of thermal shielding is going to keep us fine. And it's interesting that wasn't a concern for the first couple of nights, but then I guess it's just colder today. Alright. Phase coolant. Repair. Okay, everything is repaired. Pulse engines and launch thrusters are not charged. Let's get our launch thrusters charged first. So that got them up to 43. Okay, they're now at 100. Let's go with... we have very little of that, but we've got everything at least in a working order now. A little bit of cool stuff. Quite a bit of plutonium here at least. Okay. An emerald. Don't know what a Gek Charm actually does. It's fairly valuable though. Korvac's Convergence Cube, also fairly valuable. Okay. Starship. Time to get off this rock. Oh yes. We launch thrustered our way up. Okay. Wow. Alright, so we've got a look control. Milestone accomplished indeed. We've got the other stick for controlling the ship itself. Got acceleration. Yeah, hold R2 to accelerate, fly up using the left stick. As long as we're here. Controls. Use starship controls. Oh, I'm so looking for an invert. Flight controls normal. Flight controls inverted. Oh yes, okay. That feels so much more natural to me. Alright, and now all we need to do is get into space. Which we handle by just pointing ourselves upward and outward. Are there, like, orbits everywhere? Are we seeing, like, trade paths? Or I don't know what the lines are kind of connecting and looping around. Oh, wow. There's space rocks. System Itsumotsubli. Yeah, in the Euclid galaxy. Sure, sure. Okay. So the shoulder buttons control some fancy roll abilities. We got pitch, we got yaw. Got accelerate, we've got decelerate. Acquire hyperdrive technology. Alright, our next objective, leave the solar system. Acquire hyperdrive technology, build hyperdrive, fuel hyperdrive. So we're first going to need a blueprint from somewhere? And then once we have a blueprint, we're going to need to construct it from raw materials and then power it with fuel. Oh, and we have our next objective, a space station. Okay. Starship scanner, press L3 to activate the scanner.
Alert. Navigational data received.
Okay. I'm kind of in a situation where I'm a little afraid to just press every button, because it's like, what if one of them is eject from your spaceship? Also got a beacon. What do I want to go to first? There's a space station over there and a beacon over there. Incoming signal. I'm guessing this. Hold circle to engage boost. Oh, that didn't last very long. Oh, hold circle to keep boosting, not just engage it, huh? L1 and R1 to pulse. Oh, wow. So we're from 45 minutes to 45 seconds to 15 seconds. Beacon's not so far away anymore, huh? Can I still... Nah, I can't really navigate once I've activated the pulse drive. Okay, yeah, planetary interference. That would seem to make sense. Oh, the beacon's getting farther away as we decelerate. Alright, but if I hold my boost button, I can get a little more. Is it on the planet or on the other side of the planet, I wonder? No? Seems to be directly below us. Let's go in for a little landing look-see. Hold square to initiate landing sequence. Weather, radioactive decay, sentinels are relaxed, efficient flora, copious fauna. Alright, and then on foot, the beacon is now a minute away. Alright. I tell you what. We got into space. We flew to a near... Oh my god, will you look at this thing? Oh man. Okay, we flew to a nearby planet. The nearby planet has crazy more stuff going on. But I've got to... Oh, look at you. Look at all of you. Can I not scan? Am I too far out? A lesser man might be worried about that life support 10% warning, but I've got crazy, creepy alien life forms to scan, so I'm not even worried about it. Also, sometimes stuff that looks very similar is like a slightly different species. Like, I don't know, this one has spinier spines on its back, so it can be different. Anything with the red... Whoa. Oh, you're not a friendly plant. You're not a friendly plant at all. You got like a little gun symbol next to you, and you move. Okay, we'll check that out maybe in a future time. But anything with the green dot, we've scanned. Anything with red dot, we've not scanned. So sometimes stuff that, like, to the casual observer may appear the same is not, in fact. Oh, you're the coolest looking giant anteater animal ever. All right, I have got some life support systems to worry about. And then a beacon to go find. But look at that thing! I'm never going to be able to end any episode ever of this game. But I do think it is important that we eventually end the episode. So I hope you guys have enjoyed what we've been doing so far in No Man's Sky. If you have, feel free to subscribe. Lots more on the channel. Leave a comment or like if you have anything to say about this or any of my other videos. And I will catch you guys next time.